Some local students are preparing for the world's biggest STEM competition. We're talking 50,000 young people. Grace Cotton and Selby Lynn are two members of a six-person team, and they're here in our studio before taking off for their trip to Houston to give us a sneak peek at their robot. Look at that. Hi, Grace and Selby, how are you?
I'm good. It's great to be here.
Well, first just tell us, what school do you go to and what are your ages?
We go to Walnut Hills High School. We've been part of Cincinnati Public Schools our entire lives, and I'm 14.
I'm 14 as well.
So you're a ninth grade freshman. Okay, great. So how long have you been interested in STEM?
For a long time.
Yeah?
Yeah, when we started in fourth grade, I was very interested in STEM.
You too, Grace?
Yes, I've always been interested in STEM, and this has been a really great way to outlet that.
Okay, so as we said, this is the world's biggest STEM competition. What did you have to do just to get entered in this contest?
There are three qualifying competitions that you have to advance from in order to enter the first championship.
Okay, and that took place over how much time? Like just this year or all school year? How long have you been working on to get in?
It started in August of this year.
Wow. And so you're finally going. You must be so excited about it.
We're very excited. Yeah. This is a really big deal for us, and we're can't wait.
Yeah. Okay. So you're on a six-person team. You had to build this robot, right? Mm-hmm. Okay. Tell me what this robot is designed to do.
This robot is designed to complete as many missions as possible on the mission field in 2.5 minutes.
Okay. So some of the jobs it will do on the field are what?
We have our forklift here, which can lift up and push down missions. It can also push and pull missions.
Okay, I think we have some video of it actually in action. Do you guys want to talk about just what that is like, you know, how your team works together to get it to do all the right things?
Yeah, so during the 2.5 minutes, we are all technicians, so we all switch off changing attachments on and off the robot in order to get it done as fast as possible.
It's almost like a race car race, like the Indy 500. You guys are the pit crew.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
What are some of the other things that this robot can do? Did it take a long time to build it?
Yeah, it definitely did take a long time.
Yeah, how did you figure out how to build it to do the things it needs to do? What went into that? I'm guessing a lot of math.
Yeah, a lot of trial and error in just what we know from previous seasons.
Mm-hmm. We had a lot of different designs over previous years. We had smaller robots that were faster and could fit through tighter spaces. It just depended on what the mat looked like that year. And this year it was a lot of lifting and pushing, which is why we have the forklift.
Okay, so this is something you have done before. Mm-hmm. You're veterans in robotic competition.
Yes, this is our sixth year.
Okay. Is it your team of six, which I love the name, howl about it. Have you been together all this time? Does that help to work with the same people over and over?
Yeah, definitely.
Why?
We've become like a family. We know each other so well, and that just allows us to work so well together.
I'm guessing you almost can complete each other's thoughts.
Yeah, we know how each other think.
Yeah.
It's great.
So how is this going to prepare you for the future? What do you guys want to do in life? Do you know?
I don't know, but I know that FIRST has taught me that I love creative thinking and problem solving, and I want to do that in my career.
Yeah, Grace?
Even the things that aren't STEM related, just how to work with a group, how to do these teamwork things, how to meet people, and how to speak publicly and present things will help us in whatever we decide to go into.
Are you intimidated at all by thinking that 50,000 people are going to be at this contest?
Extremely.
Well, I know you guys are going to do great because you just did great on television. So there's one more piece of preparation off your list. Grace and Selby, good luck to you and all of your teammates. And please let us know how it goes, will you?
Thank you.
You send us some video.
Thank you. Okay.
Hey there. Yeah, you could stop watching right now, but let's be honest, you don't want to do that. Hit the links or click subscribe to see more amazing content from all of us here at Local 12.